How has Miami influenced your art?
So Miami has been an incredible awakening to my artwork as far as pushing me both emotionally and physically to really just experiment with the way that I work, to be more extroverted. It tends to be a very alive, transient city, things happening all of the time, and coming from a very small town, you know, I've kind of had a more introverted way of working, a very quiet, reflective way. And it's like Miami, you don't have a choice. It's like you're putting yourself out there, and I both love and hate it, but I know that it's really pushed me and my work to a point that I wouldn't have explored otherwise. And it's very exciting and frustrating and exhilarating, and it's a great time.
Hi.
How are you?
She's here.
So the current work that I'm making is a multidisciplinary practice, and it's a combination of both a visual art practice as well as a music-based performance art. And I would say that it is quite unique, as it's taking all the years that I've put into my own do-it-yourself sort of mentality of building my own photography career, and it's putting it into a gallery setting. It's a documentation of what is happening in the present moment, of course, but also comparing and contrasting contextually, the sort of civil rights-minded social movements, protests, women's rights, politics, and it's really comparing to the original civil rights movements, and just placing a context around that it tends to be cyclical, and there tends to be a lot of progress that needs to be made that has not been made or seemingly was made and is reverting. And so I feel it's very important to have an honest documentation of the present moment. So I'm from a very small town in northern Michigan, and my primary focus in my early education was music and music performance in a concert setting, which was a low brass instrument, the baritone. And after I studied that, I went off to college and decided that I was really interested in photography. So I moved to Florida and attended the Art Institute in Fort Lauderdale, and studied photography both in the darkroom, analog photography, 4x5 field cameras, and then eventually switched to digital as well. So probably the biggest mentors in my life have been teachers, and again, early in my education, I was lucky enough to study with a great instructor, Dennis Ormsby, at Grayling High School, Grayling Middle School, Grayling High School. And he's remains a key factor in my establishment of work ethic as well as discipline in the arts. And the next instructor would be Don Sheffield at the Art Institute of Fort Lauderdale, who taught not only photography but specifically the business of photography, which is not taught too much in the arts. You know, you're taught a lot about the history and the aesthetic. And then you have that degree, and a lot of people don't even know what to do with that degree. And the business, the art of business and photography was a huge help in my career.
sorry.
So I would say the biggest form of expression and similarity between both the photography and the music are just an immediacy of expression, which connected together initially with me being shy and studying music and not feeling like I was confident in it. And so I think that led me to photography, where I could kind of hide behind a camera and be more introverted, which then led back to music. I've circled back around now that I've gained a sort of confidence in being able to express myself and finding a way to use art to express myself. And music has led me once again to, again, an immediacy of expression, that performance art, and having to be able to stand confidently on stage and, you know, say what you are thinking.